Hey guys, so I've been pretty MIA for this video so far. I am filming a week in my life this week and it is Tuesday morning and it is about 9 o'clock. And yesterday I filmed, I'd say a good chunk of my day, not a super long chunk, but a chunk of it. I was kind of getting warmed up to filming and getting back into my routine after Thanksgiving and being out of town. So it was just kind of a hard day to film. And I was really tired and just feeling unmotivated, so it was kind of just like an adjustment day. But today I'm feeling a lot better. I'm hoping to get back into the swing of things, and I have more plans starting for the rest of the week. So yeah, I wanted to check in here because I haven't talked to you guys yet in this video. It is Tuesday morning, and today I'm going to be home pretty much the whole day. I'm going to do my morning routine. I'm going to do a workout because I have not worked out in a while. Because of the holiday, but then I also have a Target pickup order, which I'm gonna do. I will be leaving the house for that, and then I'm gonna come home, get a bunch of work done, and then later tonight I'm going over to a friend's house to watch their kiddos for them, a family I'm really close to, so I'm gonna be doing that tonight. So I'll be there most of the night, and I probably won't film there, so yeah, and then I'm gonna just come home and chill for the night. And then I will continue filming tomorrow and Thursday and the rest of the week. But yeah, I want to check in with you guys. I'm about to do my Bible study. I did actually finish Numbers, which if you guys have watched my last few videos, you know that I am going through the Bible chronologically. And so I have done the last few books I've been in have been Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus. And then I went into Numbers and finished Numbers yesterday, and I'm going into Deuteronomy today. So I'm excited to be starting a new book, And so yeah, I'm gonna be doing that this morning. And I journaled a bit, I had my breakfast, just been watching some YouTube. And after this, I'm gonna work out. Then we'll go get my Target order and get working. So I'm gonna film today and hopefully do a better job of it and do a better job of talking to you guys as well. And yeah, so I will talk to you guys in a little bit.
My friend nostalgia, I found you when I heard the sweet sound of the ones who I once knew so well. In a voice memo from years ago, we were laughing about some nonsense. Oh, how I miss those friends. Circumstances made it so that I'll never see their faces, except for on the internet, where I'll never really know what's going on, but I miss mine. I mean, I guess I could check in once in a while. But best friends are growing up, and there's no time for us to pretend we'd stay in touch, 'cause everybody knows it will never be the same.
Okay guys, I am home now from picking up my Target order. So I wanted to give you guys a little haul because I got some stuff. I got new shampoo and conditioner, some stuff for our bathroom and stuff like that. So I also got a Starbucks. I got my usual iced brown sugar oat milkshake and espresso. I was really debating on whether or not to get a peppermint mocha because that's what I'm loving right now for Christmas time. But I think I'm going to get that with my friends in a couple days, so I decided to just go with the coffee. And I could use the coffee today, so we got the coffee. Hold on. Okay, now that my dog is leaving me alone, I'm going to give you guys a haul. So, as I said, I got some bathroom stuff because I share a bathroom with my brother because we both still live at home. And it just kind of needs some revamps, like our shower curtain needs to be replaced and our shower rod, shower hooks, all that stuff needed to be replaced. So I am doing that right now. I'm in the process. So I wanted to show you guys some of the stuff I got. First up, this is the shower curtain I got, the outer curtain. And it's just a Magnolia one, which I love Magnolia. And it's black and white striped, I'd say, grayish black. And that is really cute. It was on sale, so I'm excited about that. And I'm hoping it'll hide, like, when you grab it after a while and it gets dirty, just stuff like that. So, and then I just got some basic circular ring hooks for it. We're getting a black curtain rod. We have all silver now, and every single curtain hook we've ever had is the most freaking annoying ever. They fall off, they break, they catch, like, and so yeah, we just need to replace them and get a better system going. I'm hoping that these plain circles will be basic enough to be mindless and easy. So we got those. And now, oh, I got like just a inner curtain liner. That's it for $3. So that's what that is. Not very exciting. And then I also got new shampoo and conditioner because I have been using Garnier for a long time. And I thought I should probably switch up to a better just hair care line and brand and all that stuff, clean ingredients, stuff like that. So I'm trying out the Odele brand. If any of you guys have used this, let me know what you think. I've got the smoothing shampoo and conditioner for extra moisture, frizz control and shine, sulfate-free and 100% natural fragrance. I have eczema, so I tend to have really dry skin, and if I don't keep that taken care of, especially like with my hair and stuff, it can cause drying, which then causes dandruff, and I don't want dandruff, that is for sure. So I'm hoping with the extra moisture added to it, that will be helpful for my hair. So I did a bunch of research and these seem to be a good option. So I got those, and then I think I've been noticing recently that I need more, moisture on my face, more hydration. Because I am using a retinol right now for my skin, and I have been for a while, and I just noticed that I don't think my moisturizer is strong enough and thick enough. So I use the CeraVe moisturizing lotion, I think it is, which is pretty light, pretty watery, you know, like very light moisturizer. So I thought I'd try the CeraVe moisturizing cream. It's thicker and yeah, and it's for face and body. The only thing is, I thought this was a small bottle. This is huge. Like, look at it next to my head. That is huge. And I don't know if I'm gonna like this or not for my skin. I mean, I guess if I don't like it for my face, I could use it on my body, but I don't know. I may take this back and see if I can get a smaller one, because I just don't want to end up wasting anything, because I do have a body lotion that I already really like. So knowing myself, I probably won't use this. So we will see. I may return this and get a smaller one just because I don't want to waste any products. So yeah. And then lastly, I got a refill on my probiotics for my gut. I just use the Physician's Choice Doctor Approved Formula 60 billion probiotic blend, 30-day supply. So restocked that, and that is everything. Yeah, that's pretty much everything. I did just realize that they didn't give me something, so we're gonna have to figure that out. They didn't give me my omega-3 supplement, so we will see if they charged me for it or not. And yeah, but anyways, that is my Target haul. I got a Starbucks and everything, so now I'm gonna chill. I might grab, I don't think it's really lunchtime, it's like 11, so I'm not hungry yet. I'm just gonna set up at my desk, start working, and get stuff done. So I will check back in with you guys in a little bit.
We're not
guys, it is Wednesday today, and I haven't talked to you guys today, but I have been filming a little bit. I did my morning, typical morning, and then I went on my walk. I came home and I showered because it was hair wash day, so I did that, and now I am sitting and eating lunch. I have some lentil soup and some tortilla chips, and that is my lunch. And after I eat my lunch, I plan on getting started on homework. And then at 1 o'clock, I have a advisor meeting with someone at the college that I'm hoping to get into next semester. And then I have church tonight, so I need to make slides, things like that. So yeah, we're just gonna get some stuff done today. I had a relaxing morning and productive morning, but I'm gonna eat my lunch and then get started on work. So I will check in with you guys in a little bit. Okay guys, I'm looking a little rough right now because my hair is dried from showering, not styled, so it's a bit big and crazy, so I just put it up in a messy, like, I don't even know what, to get it out of my face because it was annoying me. But I haven't checked in a bit. I ended up having my appointment an hour earlier. She called an hour earlier, so there just must have been a miscommunication with time, but that is okay because it went well, it went quick, and I got what I needed to get done. And so then I got my work done. I got all of it done, forgot to film any of it, but I did film myself doing a lot of work yesterday. So, I don't want to like keep repeating myself a bit too much. And then prepped for my class, my in-person class tomorrow. And I was just crossing my days off of my calendar and I realized that tomorrow is the last day of November. So I kind of need to start planning my new month of December. So I kind of maybe want to start doing that today, maybe write out some goals, lay out my calendar on here and stuff like that. And I may do more tomorrow. And I also would like to do some reading. I've been in a book slump for the past, I'd say, 2 to 3 weeks. I was reading The 7-Year Slip, and I think I just started reading that because I wanted to read it so badly during the fall time. I decided to read it even though I was in the mood for fantasy. And so I think I'm just in a huge fantasy mood right now. I don't want to read anything else. So I think that put me in a slump. It took me a really long time to read. And I finished that about probably close to a week ago. And I started Assassin's Blade a few days after finishing that. And I'm only... let's see. I'm only 28 pages into Assassin's Blade. So I'm having a hard time getting into this, especially because Assassin's Blade is the prequel to the Throne of Glass series. And the way I decided to read it was to read this as the third book instead of the first book. And so the huge cliffhanger we were left on in the second book, Crown of Midnight, I don't get to find anything out about that until I finish this book. So I'm kind of just having a hard time not going straight back into the story that I'm already used to and flashing back to a time that I don't know about and like feels in the past already. So it's like, I'm just having a hard time getting into this, but it's like a multiple novellas. It's not like a full story. Kind of just showing our main character's history and the history between her and her original love interest that was killed, and how that affected her and stuff. So I think it'll be easier to read just because there is multiple novellas. I marked all of them and they're pretty short as individual stories. So I feel like that'll kind of motivate me to keep reading because I'll finish one novella and then be like, okay, I finished one, like just read 100 more pages and I finish another, stuff like that. So I just wanna get some reading done. I need to just push myself to get back into it. And I think if I get a good chunk into this, I can hopefully do that. My camera battery is now flashing, so I will stop talking, but I'm gonna switch the battery and then I will film whatever I decide to do next, whether that's planning, reading, all of that stuff. And eventually I'm gonna get ready for church tonight, do my hair and my makeup and stuff like that. So I will also show you guys that. When I believe to be, maybe that's a good thing. Sometimes I'm a loner. I wish that you lived closer. Maybe then I feel alright. Sometimes I get strung out trying to be myself when you come closer.
Okay, so I quickly just did my monthly layout on my physical calendar. I just like to put, I put like church services on there, which I know I have. My church does a lot of different activities or groups on certain Sundays, so I wrote all of those down. We have Christmas Eve and Christmas. My friends and I either do a walk during the week or a Bible study, so I have that. Different things, like this Saturday I have a Christmas brunch. One of my best friend's birthdays, I have an appointment next week, I have classes on these days, and I have, my classes are ending on this day, so then my break starts here. That is what I have on my calendar right now. This is zoomed in, I think. Okay, so yeah, that's kind of what I did. I just did that really quick. I'm very scatterbrained, so I messed up a few times, and that really bothers me, but it's fine. That is just what I have. I will definitely be adding things throughout the month as things come up, or I get notifications that I have an appointment or something like that. That is what I have, and I think I might do my computer calendar as well. And then I like to do a monthly Pinterest board, which, you know, I think I might have already done that. Yes, I do believe I did that. I just realized that I did that already, thinking about Christmas starting after Thanksgiving, so I did December. So I did do my December Pinterest board already, just kind of inspo of what I want the month to look like. But I think I might also maybe journal like a few things that I want to do with maybe my friends or something in the Christmas season. And stuff like that. But overall, I think that's pretty much it for monthly planning. I don't make it very difficult or complicated or heavy because I don't want to discourage myself by not meeting goals or things like that. So that's what I do. And I think I also want to work on Christmas gift planning for family and friends. The ball needs to start rolling, and I've already come up with some ideas. My friend group's doing Secret Santa stockings, so I know my person for that, and so I need to start shopping for those things. I think I just want to sit down and do that since I have time. If not, I'll get to it another day, but yeah, that's kind of what's just going on in my monthly plan for December. Nothing too crazy, because December is just such a crazy month already. I don't want to stress myself out more and make it more complicated. But it is cool to know that I have like a 3-week break now for Christmas. I didn't realize that, but the new college that I'm going to be going to in January doesn't start till like January 8th, I think. And my classes end on December 15th, I'm pretty sure. So I will get 3 weeks off. That's awesome to hear. And yeah, that's where I'm at right now. I will check back in when I do something else interesting. Hey guys, so it is Sunday and I did not film anything yesterday, which was Saturday, because it was just kind of a busy day. We had our church's ladies Christmas brunch and I helped a lot with that, and then spent half the day there and then came home, hung out with one of my friends since it was her birthday, and just came home and relaxed with my family. So I didn't really film much yesterday, just kind of was in the present and distracted. And then Friday, I don't remember what I filmed. I don't know if I filmed anything. So I apologize for that. It's just kind of been a hectic week, an overwhelming week for me. But today is Sunday, so today will be the last day that I film for this week in my life. And because I didn't film much the last 2 days, I thought I would film some of my day today. It is kind of hard to film on Sundays. I don't usually film on Sundays, just because I attend church and I do a lot at my church. And I just like to be present more on these days. It's hard to film and stuff like that. But because of today's situation, the week in my life, I'm going to try and film as much as I can today and show you guys what I'm doing. It is currently the morning before church this morning. I just did my hair and my makeup, and now I'm going to put on my outfit. So I will show you guys that. I need to make my bed, brush my teeth, and just kind of get freshened up. And then I will be heading out here in about probably 20-30 minutes. So I will take you guys along.